Time to get the married person's view of things as we head into 2021. What'd you learn about yourself last season?
You kind of got to persevere. Last year was a different year, to say the least. I think everybody had their own ups and downs and battles with COVID and playing through a pandemic and stuff like that. But I think the thing most people probably learned was just the resiliency that kids have and the community had and everybody else. We were young, you know, and at times COVID probably affected us a little bit more than it did some other teams. But we tried to battle through it, and I think that's the one thing probably that was the big takeaway is, you know, you can't take anything for granted. You know, we're just thankful we were able to play and thankful we're semi back to somewhat normal right now, though that could change, I guess. But I would say overall that was the big thing, just the resiliency and all the things you had to ask not only the kids to do, but the coaches as well, from a protocol standpoint, you know, and probably one of the biggest differences was that we noticed the way we handled things at Mary Persons was you just didn't get to spend as much time around the kids, and which I think from the standpoint of a lot of coaches, that's probably one of the main reasons why we all do it. So it was definitely trying at times, but we're still here, baby. We're still here.
So then look at 2021 for me, and the way that I like to break things down is the three seasons. That first season, your non-region, which gets you ready for your second season, the region, which you hope gets you ready for your third season. When you look at that first season for you this season, what do you see?
Well, you know, we've only got two non-region games, the way our region lines up and how many teams we got in it, you know. And I think the biggest part is, kind of like it was last year, just learning a lot about ourselves. We're still fairly young. You know, if we played a game tomorrow, we wouldn't have any seniors starting on defense and only a couple starting on offense. So we're filling the majority of our lineup with juniors and sophomores, and which that's exciting. But for the short term and what have you done for me lately, it'll make you lose your hair a little bit. So we're hoping that we can gain a little experience and kind of find what group works good together and what lineup works good together. And then the second season you start talking about is, the first game's Peach County in the region, and that's no fun. And then you got Chris County, and you got Jackson, you got Central, you got all these other good teams. So we're hoping we can be there in the end to see the third season.
What does football mean to this part of the world?
It means a lot, you know. I think you and I have talked about this at length sometimes about the history and tradition this program has and going way back. You know, I'm the fourth head coach since the early 1950s, mm-hmm. which that can't be said for a lot of places. And then at the same time, it's still small town USA. I mean, it's shut down Friday night. Everybody goes to the games. It matters, you know. You can't go in the grocery store or to Walmart or go get your car washed or do anything else in this town without how we looking this year. How we gonna be? What do we look like? And I sure hope we're better than last year. Yeah. If you hope you're better than last year, what do you think I feel like? So you get that everywhere, which I think some people would see that as a negative, but it's really a positive because that tells you that people care about it and it's important and they want to know. And then it's another community sometimes that people don't go anywhere. So there's kids on this team, their dad played, their granddad played, their uncle played, you know, their older brother played. And that's kind of neat, you know what I mean? So it means a lot to this community.
And someone who means a lot to this community, and I'm going to continue to use that in a present tense, is Coach Dan Pitts, lost to us in the offseason. How did he impact you in your time here at Mary Persons? How did he rub off on you?
Well, you know, Coach Pitts was my next-door neighbor. So there were a lot of times, Saturday mornings, he'd be out walking, Wednesday nights, Tuesday nights, off-season, everything else like that, where we had many a conversations in the street right in front of mine and his house, you know, about it could be anything from The way we do film now with all the technology compared to the way he did it, the way they practice compared to what we did, the different rules and how football, the game of football has grown. And I would say the one thing that he probably did more than anything was support me in this football program, regardless of how we did it.